Do you think I need some new gloves?
All right, here we go. This is tricep day, and I'm just doing some overhead presses here. And I'm using 15 pounds right now, and I do two sets with the 15 pound dumbbell. And I do like 10 or 12 of them. Here I bumped it up to 20 pounds, and I did three sets of 10 or 12 with the 20 pound. You can see John over there on the bench. It's chest day for him. Since he's using the bench, I wanted to use the incline bench for my next exercise. But since he's using the bench, I decided to use the bench on the rowing machine, and it actually worked out really well. This is just a twist on the tricep kickback. I actually saw this exercise on a video from Mike O'Hearn. And that's a really good channel too. And just for the record, it's pretty easy on the eyes. But I did one set with the 15s. And I felt like it was just a little bit too much weight for me to use for this because, well, for one thing, my triceps are weak. So right there, I'm putting a 1 1/4 pound donut on to make it a little bit heavier. The reason I thought the 15s were a little bit too heavy is because I thought my form was really bad on them. So the 10s felt a little bit too light. So that's why I put the little donut on the 10 pound weights to make it 11 1/4 pounds. Seemed a little bit light. I'm trying to keep my arms from going up too far, the weights, so that I keep my biceps out of it. So this is the first time I've ever done this particular exercise, so I'm trying to work on the form. I actually got 16, so I decided to bump it up just a little bit more, and I used the 2 1/2 pound donut this time. So I'm using 12 1/2 pound dumbbells for this one, and it seemed to be pretty good. Like I said, my triceps are weak, so still working on the form, trying not to involve my biceps. I did two sets of these with the 12 1/2 pounds. Okay, so now I'm going to move on to skull crushers, which is another tricep exercise for anybody that maybe doesn't know. And I go pretty light on, gotta get rid of the hair clip. All right, I go pretty light on the skull crushers though, because they really, really kill my triceps. So I don't remember exactly how many I did or what weight I'm using, but it looks like the 10s. So I'm showing you my little sissy tricep workout here. But in my defense, my triceps are a little fatigued by now anyway, so we'll go with that. Yep, got to get a little cardio in here and try to stay out of John's way while he's still doing his chest workout. I'm not going to film every single minute, but I usually hoop through one song. So, and then I'll move on to some other kind of cardio, which I did. I moved on to punching the redneck punching bag. still trying to work on my form too. I thought I did pretty good, but John said I need to put more shoulders into it, like put my body into it a little bit more. So, but it's a good cardio workout anyway. I'm just punching the bag. I'm not trying to beat anybody up or anything, right? Next is going to be bicep day.
All right, bicep day. I'm getting ready to warm up the biceps right now because he says I'm going to love this one. So that means it's going to kick my ass. What are you helping me do?
You're running the rack.
I'm running the rack.
All right, so I'm not going to cut anything out of this particular workout on bicep day because I want you guys to see that you don't have to be in the gym for hours to get in a good workout. I'm starting with the 25-pound dumbbells, and I get them 4 times. I'm supposed to be going to failure with each weight. No breaks in between. Now I'm on the 20s, using the 20-pound dumbbells. I'm gonna get 12 of these. But yeah, I just want to kind of show that, you know, sometimes you just don't have time to work out or, you know, whatever. But you don't have to spend hours in the gym when you're lifting. You really don't. Moving on to the 15s. I get 10 of these. Yeah, you get to see all my crazy faces that I make too. That's all right. I guess I don't really care. See, I'm starting to get fatigued because I forgot what I was doing. So yeah, these are the 10s, and I actually get 20. With these, but I try to like give a little pause at the bottom so that I don't use momentum to bring them back up. Really keep those biceps involved. I promise you, I'm feeling the burn right now. All right, on to the 5s. I don't know if you could hear what I just asked John, but I asked him if I have to do those to failure because I could do them for a long time. I do have some stamina, so I probably could do those for a super long time, even with the burn that I have going on, so. What I did was I just did them until the burn got like super intense, and then I stopped. So. I don't know how many I did. I really don't feel like counting them, so.
So, what you just saw me do, he says I'm done for today. So, Tell them why.
We ran the rack.
Yeah. So, you don't.
Tomorrow's back day.
Oops, sorry.
Tomorrow's back day.
Look up. Yeah, so he said that back day is a popular day to tear a bicep.
I didn't say popular, but.
Well, what did you say? Common. That's why you're supposed to be explaining it. You're not.
The most common time that a bicep is torn is on back day.
Like deadlifts and rows and stuff? Yeah. I was planning on doing deadlifts tomorrow, so he said that I'm done.
For today. Biceps would be too
big. It seems weird because it took like, well, you saw it.
Just getting the pump and getting out.
Ooh, look at that light. I'm not cutting anything out of it, so however long it was on the video, that's how long it was.
Just getting a quick pump and we're out. Biceps will get work tomorrow.
I'm back there. Okay, see you tomorrow.
And it is back day. I'm choosing to do deadlifts for this day, and I warmed up already. I always warm up. So, just so you guys know, I don't film the warm-ups. But this is 95 pounds. John said to do sets of 6 or 8, so I'm doing sets of 8. Which, during editing, I realized that I actually did 9, but, you know, I meant to do 8, so. This is me getting psyched up to do another set. So I did pretty good on my form with the first set, especially good. With this set, I see that I'm doing something wrong, and I noticed it while I was doing this set too. But I never corrected it until the very last one. Oh, and by the way, I'm using 115 pounds for this one. And I did 3 sets of them with the 115 pounds. Psyched up for my next set. What I'm doing wrong is I'm at the bottom. When I put it down, I'm bending my elbows a little and jerking the weight back up. That's what I don't want to do. A little jerk. Right there. Don't want to do that. Like I said, I realized I was doing it and I corrected it on my very last one. But I'll definitely keep it in mind for next time though. All right, now this is the last thing that I'm doing. It's gonna be my my last clip, I guess. Seated rows. This is just the 50 pounders. Well, not 50 pounders, but I've got 50 pounds on the machine. I did 2 sets of 10 with 50 pounds, and I bumped it up to 70. Can you hear it hitting the bottom every time? That's John telling me not to do that. But I didn't hear him. So yeah, that's a what not to do. He said you want to keep tension on that particular exercise, so I speeded back a little bit. And I did a total of 3 sets with 70 pounds. After this, you're going to see some bloopers. And just so you know, the very last blooper is John yelling. The dog is barking like a maniac outside, And since we're inside the garage, he like screams really loud at the dog. It's just hilarious. Crack me up. Thanks for watching, guys. And I will see you in the next video.
As soon as I hit record, you say that. I have to have it way up there in order to be able to get us both in here.
I'm squatting.
You're squatting? Okay. So anyways, you have to look up a little because you can't see your eyeballs.
Ah!
I'm recording.